It's been one of, it's been the most amazing thing to be involved with, but the it's been so, so difficult. Really, really challenging. You know, you get so married to books that you love, and then to have to lose them at long list and at short list, you know, it's really upsetting. But then, you know, it was an amazing thing to be part of. It was like having your fantasy book club, really, like Shami Chakrabarty and Laura Bates and Kathy Newman. It was just great. It was great. We've had a great time.
Why is it important to have nights like tonight that particularly celebrate women in the arts?
Well, I think that, you know, we don't live in an equal world. I wish that we did. And I'd love to be at a point where we don't have to have these parties. But, you know, I think that it's so easy time and time again to sometimes concentrate on what men are achieving in the literary world, whether it's through book sales or whether it's like the positioning they get in bookstores. And, you know, when we do this, we just try to push that, you know, women are writing about wars. They're writing about spying. They're writing about, you know, really, really meaty subjects. And we should be celebrating that, and I hope that we are.
Is there a particular book that's really left a big impression on you? Do you have a favourite book?
Oh, well, I can't say which one of the books tonight is my favourite because I wouldn't want to upset anybody. But what I did, I lost a book from the long list that I wanted to go through to shortlist, which was Station 11 by Emily St. John Mandel, which breaks my heart that it didn't go through because it's like dystopian fiction and it's not a genre I'm into, but I love this book so much and it's gone.